Welcome to the 15 minutes of Dr. Leo Pruimboom. Today, it's only in English, so everybody who are following this 15-minute session will learn and use English, and because we cannot use all the languages every Tuesday. Today it's about a case. I was preparing a scientific paper about the impact of periodontal disease on systemic problems. And I remembered a case which I would like to share with you, because that for me was an incredible moment of deep learning. A man visited me as a patient with rheumatoid arthritis, and he was really in agony. Years of suffering, and after years of suffering and visiting more than 30 specialists, from rheumatologist to immunologist to physiotherapist, etc., he came to me and he was desperate. So after doing the anamnesis, the diagnostic measurements, I really couldn't find something else than all the other specialists. And then you probably know, if you repeat the same treatment in a person who is already on the way for more than 20 years, that intervention will never ever be successful. So I told the guy, give me a week or something to find out what possibility it could give, related with his very progressive rheumatoid arthritis, which did not react on painkillers, on anti-inflammatory substances, and even on biotherapy. So he said, okay, yeah, and he liked it, you know, because it would be very, very weird if I would have been able in only 1 hour to successfully determine all the etiological causes and risk factors of his rheumatoid arthritis. So I told him, come back in a few weeks, and then I've studied your case, and we'll see what I can do. So he went away, and when he got out of my consultation bureau, he touched his right foot with a plant in my garden. He went home, and when he came home, his foot started to itch. And to itch, and it got red and red and red and red. And he got fever, and he phoned me and he said, Leo, I don't know what happened, but I opened up my skin in your garden because of a plant, and now my skin is itching, it's red, and I have fever, not very high, but I have fever. So I went out, I looked at that plant, and it was a kind of a fat plant. And I thought, wow, could it be that he got some bacterial infection? So I said, go to your family doctor and give me the telephone number, I'll phone him, because it could be that you need an antibiotic. And he said, I've never taken any antibiotic in my life. Why should I do now? I said, yeah, because I don't want you to have a blood infection. And then he went to the family doctor urgently. It was an urgent case. He gave me the telephone number. I phoned her. I explained what happened. And she prescribed an antibiotic, what really was a necessity. And then a miracle happened, because after 3 days of using the antibiotic medicine, he started not only to improve at the level of the wound on his leg, but also his joints started to improve. Inflammation got better, he had less pain, and he could move better. 7 days after using the antibiotic treatment, he was free of joint inflammation. So he found, he said, Leo, what has happened is incredible. My rheumatoid arthritis, all my joints are not inflamed anymore. They are not red. I have hardly any pain. What has happened here? And I said, wow, could you come back to my consultation and let me have a look? Because what you are telling me is really supporting my first hypothesis. So he came and I already had looked in his mouth, and his mouth was not very healthy. He really suffered from periodontal diseases. He suffered from gingivitis. He had caries. And so he came, and I did a more thorough investigation in his mouth. Yeah. And we made, we sent the saliva to a labor to see if there was growth of periodontal bacteria. And his mouth was full with Streptococcus mutans, with Fusobacteria, and with Treponema bacteria, the whole bunch of periodontal bacteria. And when we then looked to the spectrum of the antibiotic he took to solve the infection of his skin, we saw that antibiotic was a wide spectrum antibiotic, which also functions against Streptococcus and Treponema bacteria. So because of a real coincidence, we found that rheumatoid arthritis, yeah, and everybody knows, but normally a bacterial rheumatoid arthritis is normally acute, is normally not chronic and not so long lasting. And in his case, it didn't start acute. It started really bit by bit. So it was not a logical bacterial rheumatoid arthritis. And this is more than 20 years ago, and it opened up my eyes about the possibility that infections or subclinical infections could be part of the big film of chronic diseases. Since then, I've been investigating researches all kind of bacteria, virus, and endotoxemic situations as the cause of the cause of causes. And gradually, we have found out, also together with a very good friend and ex-student of me, Karin Punder, and we found out that almost all chronic diseases are related with endotoxemia. So rheumatoid arthritis, psoriasis, atherosclerotic plagues, but also Alzheimer and many other diseases, we always find lipopolysaccharides and lipopolysaccharides binding protein, which indicates that the people are really suffering an infection. So, Therefore, it is time that medicine in general occupies itself much more with the film behind the photo of a chronic disease than only treating the photo. We developed that meta model more than 30 years ago from the photo to the film. Yeah, and if you really understand the photo, you can develop a film. And film medicine, that's real systemic medicine, and the clinical PNI. So I could tell you so many anecdotes of that since this man showed me that a long-lasting endotoxemia, and afterwards we came to much more interesting conclusions, because his film was huge. He said, "I suffer from caries since I'm small," and I asked him, "And did you eat a lot of sweet food?" And he said, "No, and I don't like sweet food." And I said, "That is weird. That is weird." And did you have a bad mouth hygiene? I said, "No, I had a perfect mouth hygiene, but I always had caries. Yeah, I had always bleeding gums, and we've never understood it." And then I asked him, and that was then, because I didn't know the pathway behind it, if he had a bad youth, and the thing is, the poor boy was an orphanage. His parents died when he was 1 year old. And today I understand what then happened, because we know that emotional and chronic emotional risk factors function through a system which is called the emotional motor system, which changes the complete environment in the mouth and can be responsible for a change in the composition of the saliva. And that is what we measured then in him, and together, and today we find that in an incredible amount of patients, a mouth which is one of the most important organs if you really want to do systemic medicine. And today we have found so often people with periodontal diseases and a very, very sour saliva, which means that then in the mouth there are so-called anaerobic bacteria, and the mouth should be full with aerobic bacteria, and there shouldn't be any anaerobic bacteria. That's not true. There can be a certain amount, but they should never dominate. And that saliva can change because of emotional trauma. Yep. Which is very important also for all the dentists in the world, because they talk about sweetness, they talk about hygiene, but we forget about the incredible impact of chronic toxic emotions and mouth health. And that's the 15 minutes of Leo Pruimboom. I told you it would be in English. I hope that you can follow me in English. The good thing is I'm a Dutch-speaking English person, and that makes it normally easier for foreigners to follow the English language. Next week, we'll be back again. The first session, you remember, was about the coronavirus. The second was about a case. And next week, we're going to talk about top sports, about why people like very good tennis players, as David Ferrer, who now is retired, but has been more than 10 years belonging to the top 10. Yeah. And also other very interesting top sports athletes, which I have been able to guide in their career. And we'll talk about how to make sports people better than the best. Thank you very much. Until next week.